On today's show, I'm bringing back a returning guest. They were back on my show back in February 2018. We are talking about no other than PCT Ltd. I want your ears to perk up for this company because I think they're getting ready to knock it out of the park here in the next two or three quarters. You can find them on the OTC markets. Ticker symbol PCTL. And with us today, we're very fortunate and lucky to have him as the CEO and chairman and president of the company, Mr. Gary Grieco. Gary, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be back.
You know, I am so excited about your company. You guys have been coming on the show now for probably over 2 years.
And correct.
You finally got one of your products in the British hospitals. How did that come about? And tell us about what is that going to do for the company?
Okay. One of the things is expanding our market. I mean, the U.S. is pretty doggone big, and believe me, it's huge, but it's still limited. There's like 6,500 hospitals. One of our shareholders, this is one of how these things develop, had a very, very good friend that was involved in the healthcare business in England. He showed him the product. We had a bunch of dialogue going back and forth. They made a trip over to the United States, went to the Brooklyn Hospital, which is the SUNY hospital in Brooklyn, New York, went through everything, saw this product in operation and how it worked and talked to the people. And we recently shipped over a system, sent the people over, got it all up and running, and they commenced testing on the 15th of this month. And unless their microbes are different than ours, we're going to have the same success we have in this country. and that is the reason that is can be so exciting for us is that the British healthcare system has taken a keen interest in what they're doing and what we're doing. And although this is strictly verbal, and but they have indicated upon successful testing and all the things that we have to go through, that they will recommend very strongly that all their hospitals in the UK start having this product.
Gary, I want you to take it one step further. Tell my listeners, you know, what kind of product and what kind of business you guys are in, and tell us a little bit about your flagship product. What does it
all right,
do?
Well, hypochlorous acid is the product that we manufacture. Hypochlorous acid has been around for 4 or 5 decades. It is a non-corrosive, very benign disinfectant. The problem with it's had problems was it didn't, when I say it didn't travel well, it didn't have a great shelf life. The product never lended itself, nor will it, to bottling it and selling it in supermarkets. I mean, you know, that's the perver of bleach, et cetera.
Right.
So what we've done is we've taken our history of working with the product and developed a system for hospitals where it's generated on site on demand. So those problems of how old is it still good, are gone. The problem with getting into the hospitals, now we got into our first hospital actually a little over 2 years ago in November of 17, I'm sorry. And that's in Smithfield, North Carolina. They started with one system. They've gotten and since ordered a second system. They're working with two systems. And in this first quarter, we'll be getting a third system from them. It is just a long, arduous problem getting into the hospitals because of the layers of people that you have to go through. First, you have to go through the infectious control people, which makes a lot of sense. After you meet with them, you meet with the hospital administrators. That makes a lot of sense. Then it's, well, how much will it cost and what will the savings be? Now you meet higher up. And trying to get all these people together at one time is a very difficult task. So we have found that from the initial discussion with a hospital, it takes approximately 6 months before we get one in there. Because it's new, because it's a game changer for them, a lot of them have been reticent. So we've always had to say, we put it in, it was 60 days, now it's 30 days, and at the end of the first quarter, you either buy it, it'll be ready. We just installed a system just a week before Christmas in New York, another hospital. We solved another major problem with another hospital in New York. They're going back to see them next week. We've got another install later in the month. So we should get two systems installed this month.
Well, here's what I find very ironic.
Yeah, right.
People go to the hospital to get well. But what we found out that when people go to the hospital, they actually get more diseases, infections in the hospital before they get there. So my question is, what I'm trying to say is, what exactly does your product do?
Well, it kills any tested pathogen, and by that I mean bacteria and viruses that it's ever been gone against. With C. diff, which is the biggest problem that's on our label of our product, MRSA, the really bad, and those super bugs, which they've been dubbed, are simply mutations of other ones that, using bleach and peroxide and some of the other things on them, they eventually build up an immunity to them where they have little or no effect. Ours kills differently. It kills the bacteria by destroying the DNA. So if it can get to it, it's dead. You don't have a partial. You don't have some of them that got dosed but didn't die, and then they, as they begin to break into and making new viruses and new bacteria, they develop an immunity to it. That is the significant difference.
Okay, real quick, what's the competition in this space? Are you guys the only one that has this product?
No. A lot of people have the product. There is nobody that has a system, because it's more than the product. We have, as I say, the generation. We have electrostatic sprayers, which they do the rooms with. We have a room sprayer, which is a terminal cleaning a piece of apparatus that when people leave the hospital, all the rooms must be terminally cleaned. And a room can be terminally cleaned with our system in 10 minutes, which would take 30 to 40 minutes by hand. And this was told to me by an administrator. He said, you got to view us like a hotel. If we discharge 40 people, 30 of them get discharged at 9:30, and the other 10 right after dinner. And I can't make money for this hospital until I turn those rooms over. Excuse me.
Absolutely.
So you can get one person with three of these, because no hospital just has one of these rooms. They'll go in. They'll use the hand sprayer in the bathrooms because the portal may not be big enough to get enough of the electrolyzed analyte in there. So they do that by hand, do the high-touch areas with Catholite, which is the other product we make, set the unit, push it 8 minutes, go to the next room. So by the time she's finished in the third room, she goes to the first room, is done. So one person could be cleaning three rooms. And that is a cost saver for the hospital. But more than that, it allows them to get more people into the rooms quicker.
I want to talk to you about, you put out a couple of press releases. I want to really talk about the health of your business and it's progressing. You recently signed an agreement with Sunny Downstate Medical Center for $500,000, Ace Janitorial. I think you're working with an oil company or a cannabis company. Bring us up to speed of what's going on with that.
Okay. The Brooklyn Hospital, that's SUNY, that's State University of New York's hospital system. They had a system in there for a year. And it was at the end of October of last year, it was up for renewal. And we normally ask for a minimum of 2 years to 3 years for a contract. They insisted on 5.
Absolutely.
Which was, I think that speaks
volumes
for what this product and what the hospital thinks of it. Correct. We've got limited time here. We've been doing expanding into the oil and gas area and been doing testing in Oklahoma on some gas wells that are carrying high amounts of hydrogen sulfide, which is extremely corrosive and deadly. Our results have been more than gratifying. Next week, we're going to have a major company called Caleb Brent, B-R-E-T-T, come in and retest everything that we've done to verify what our results are. Because when we go to people, they're sort of self-serving when we did the testing. And then the other thing that that was been very explosive to me, because it was totally new, is the cannabis business that is growing by all over the country.
Yep, leaps and bounds.
Yes, by leaps and bounds. And we've been asked a lot of questions, and the biggest question is, how will it treat mold? Well, it treats mold. It kills any kind of mold there is. Now,
right.
The way they currently treat it is with peroxide, which works. Don't misunderstand. But that has residuals. It also is more expensive. And the way that we're developing a system to deliver the product, whether it's an indoor facility, outdoor, we have backpack sprayers that are electrostatic that you would walk between the rows, or if it's a big enough operation, you pull it through with a sprayer that would get the plants, which would make sure that the plant doesn't get any mold, any E. coli, or any salmonella, because those are the three things that are very, very negative to them. It is done with, instead of using NaCl as a base, it's potassium-based, which is a nutrient for the plant. Our initial testing has been spot on. Oh, and I want to bring up, just let me bring up one thing about the hospitals.
Wow.
Every hospital we've gotten into has kept the system. Not one of them is, and now we're pushing 10. It is, you know, that is a whole lot, but in our world it is, because it's so difficult to get there.
Well, it's 100% retention rate. That's awesome.
Yeah, it is. It is. Once they get to use it, I mean, as I say, they're always reticent, but once they get it and their people use it and they see the results, they keep it.
Gary, we got about 30 seconds left here for the show. In your closing arguments, what do you want my listeners and your stockholders to take away from the interview today?
That we've gone through some really rough times. The ship estate has been stabilized, and our growth potential is better and bigger than it ever was before.
Well, I've looked at the company and I looked at your financials. I really think you guys are going to have some hyper growth. And I said it earlier in the beginning of the show, in the second and third quarter, very undervalued here at a $1.25 million market cap. I want my listeners to take a look at this company, because I think they're going to do some great things in 2020. Gary, I want to thank you for stopping by and coming on the show. The only thing I ask
is, let's do it more often.
Exactly. That's what I was going to say. You know, you staying away too long. That's almost a year you've been on the show.
Well, you know, there were so many things. You know, we needed to have more hospitals. We needed to get these testing done in the oil and gas industry, and now in the cannabis industry. Now I'm going to start to have a lot of things to talk about often.
This program is entirely sponsored and produced by La Jolla Media LLC, which is responsible for the content. The opinions and information provided on this program are for educational and research purposes. Stock Day encourages all listeners of this program to do their due diligence and research when determining investment strategies that will work for them, or to seek the assistance of an investment professional.